Hello, welcome to Showtime. And today we will make a spoiler review of Star Wars The Force Awakens. So see you on the other side. Hello and welcome to Showtime. And today we're gonna do a spoiler review of Star Wars The Force Awakens. Now, if you have not seen this movie yet, please click on above right here to the link and it will take you to a spoiler-free review. So let's get straight to it. There is two or three things I didn't like about the movie, or they could have been executed in a different way. The first thing is the third act towards the end is the attack on the Starkiller base. It could have been longer. It was too short for me. Also, I didn't feel threatened by this Starkiller base. Not like the Death Star. Now, you know me. I don't like to dwell in the past. I like to look to the future. And I don't want to compare the Death Star with the Starkiller base. But all I want to say is, at least in A New Hope, I had this threat. I felt this feeling that there was something that was coming, and there was something to be, when you care about the characters in the movie and there is this threatening thing that is going to kill off all the characters that you invested time in to watch, you feel you're caring about these characters. And in The Force Awakens, the Starkiller base, I didn't feel it as a threat. So that was one of the things I particularly didn't like. The next thing was the ending of the movie. I felt that it could have been done in a particular or better way. Just Rey's character meeting Luke Skywalker, they look at each other and that was it. I didn't like that. I thought it could be done in a different way. The next thing was also Kylo Ren. I would have liked to see just him taking off in a ship and going to another planet, just leaving. These three things I didn't like. But this movie is excellent. J.J. Abrams did a fantastic job with the new cast and the old cast. Brilliant, even the way the Millennium Falcon was introduced. When you're there on Jakku, and you got Finn and Rey running, and she calls that ship over there junk, and the camera doesn't pan over there. You don't see the Millennium Falcon. And then when it's introduced, when they run to it, there you just see it. It's so iconic. I was in the cinema, my heart started beating when I saw the Millennium Falcon. It was amazing. So, I like the story. I can't wait to see episode 8 in 2.5 years. And we all know next year there's gonna be Rogue One. And that should be the film between episode 3 and episode 4. So yes, go and see this movie. If you're a Star Wars fan, go and see it. I've given this movie a rating of 9 out of 10. It is a good movie. Just these three minor things, they're only minor, that I really particularly didn't like. Also, it was very subtle, the way that Chewbacca and Han Solo was introduced again. I liked it. It wasn't so epic, it was just subtle and it had the right tone to it. But with Luke, I wanted more. I was waiting to see Luke for so long and that was it. I felt a bit cheated, but it's a good movie. And I would say, if you can, see it twice. I saw it in Italian, and I've got to say the dubbing was excellent, and then I saw it in English. But if you can see it two or three times, because there's always going to be things that you miss. Then usually the first time you watch a movie like this, you don't see everything. So see it two or three times, and you'll understand why. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to Showtime, and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.